I'm going to try to get through this presentation, which was originally designed for 30 minutes in Philadelphia. I cut it down to 10, and to do this, I'm going to have to use my New York speaking voice. I live in New Jersey, but I grew up in New York, and I can talk fast, which bothers the people from the South I work with. All right, what is GSOW, Guerrilla Skeptics, on Wikipedia? We're a well-trained and dedicated international group of volunteers working in many languages, and we work diligently to improve the science and skeptical content of the world's number one improved information source, Wikipedia. Okay. Not going to go through the whole thing like that, really. But our ultimate goal is to eradicate all the woo on Wikipedia. Yeah, like that's going to happen. But we do try our best. That's our goal, to minimize the woo, alt-med, pseudoscience. And we fight the battle against the forces of the dark side all the time. There's editors who just don't even think of it. They think that psychics are real, and there are ones who really, really believe it and try to put that on the encyclopedia. They definitely have the numbers. As you know, skeptics are in the minority no matter where we go. But we have the skills. We've been trained to do this properly. And most of the time, the people on the other side don't know what they're doing. We know what the rules and guidelines of Wikipedia are, which are vast. And because of the training I've received on this team, we know how to deal with those things. We know what the corporate culture of Wikipedia is. It's just like another company. There's people who've been editing for 10 years or more, and they know the rules. And if you do the wrong thing, you can spend an hour to put something on and it'll get immediately erased. It's a very, very frustrating thing. So one of the really good things about Wikipedia is articles have to reflect scientific consensus. They're definitely on the side of science and skepticism. And this is a follow-up to that in their official announcement, that there can be representative of alternative to science orthodoxy, however, pseudoscience does not count. You do not need to be fair and balanced regarding pseudoscience or alt-med. So why does Wikipedia matter at all? Well, it's the fourth most popular site in the English-speaking world. Those are the only ones above it. And of course, those aren't really bastions of knowledge. Google is a great search engine, and in fact, it helps us because it points to Wikipedia. The other reason is journalists use Wikipedia. We have an example that we'll show you one later, where they go and they read our article when they're gonna write something about something that they are interested in, and they find a Wikipedia article and it changed their mind and it might change what they write. And also importantly, Michael Scott says it's important.
Here's the best thing ever. Anyone in the world can write anything they want about any subject. So you know you are getting the best possible information.
And despite that sarcastic opinion, actually it ranks up there Encyclopedia Britannica and all the reviews that are done. In fact, if you look at a movie review, it might be not so accurate, but anything that's science or skepticism related is very accurate. So what do? We write brand new articles from scratch when there's a subject that we see that hasn't been covered. If we find a subject that we're interested in that's been covered but covered badly, we rewrite the article. We make many, many small improvements, probably by a factor of 10 or 100 even more than writing new articles, which improves articles that already exist but have problems. One of which might be in the main article, you might have some critical content, but the original author did not put it in the lead, which is a little part above the table of contents. And most people won't frankly read the entire article. They read the first little two paragraphs and stop. So we'll take the criticism already in the article and stick it in the lead. I also have an example of that right now. Tyler Henry, anybody know Tyler Henry? So Voyant Media, he's been on E! Television Network for 3 years. He has always written about CNN, any publication you can imagine, they've written articles on him. They think he talks to dead people. This was the article before GSOW got to it, basically just describing the show. And this is what we did to it. Upper right, we flagged it as paranormal. Now the lead part, which is above the table of contents, the red box is around a summary of all the skepticism now in the article. So someone stumbles upon this and basically it says it's bullshit. So besides doing skepticism, we also do science. So we write articles about the skeptical spokespeople in this movement and those involved in science directly, voluntarily or not. One was Alan Hale. Oh, not him. Yeah, astronomer Alan Hale, co-discoverer of Hale-Bopp Comet. I actually did that article. There's a local astronaut from New Jersey, Bob Senker, had a page that was 3 lines long. Now it's actually a good article on Wikipedia. And the one and only AstroCat. Yes, there's a thing, look it up. Wikipedia page, so list it up. So how do people find the articles? Well, there's a search engine in Wikipedia, but you have to know what you're looking for. WikiLinks are important. Those are the links within any article to go to other ones. And what we have done is put WikiLinks to drive people to our articles. The other big one is Google. You Google something like Tyler Henry, and what do you get? All the first hits up there are his show, YouTube videos or articles by US Weekly or whatever that say, oh yeah, he can talk to dead people. But off on the right side there, there's a link to a Wikipedia article that Google provided for anyone interested. And then you would get that article that you saw before where it says, no, it's nonsense. Another example, a little politics in the news. The United States accused Cuba of a sonic attack. And basically, if you did a Google search on that before there was a Wikipedia article, you'd get all these hits regarding, oh, it's a mystery, we don't know what's going on. Well, we wrote this article, or actually updated it significantly, to change it from we don't know what's going on to saying it's most likely mass psychogenic illness. And it's not just our opinion on that. That was quoting scientists who said that. As I mentioned, journalists use Wikipedia. Ronda Rousey, an MMA champion, Olympian. USA Today Sports decided to write an article about her. And as it turns out, the author of that article read ours because he quoted the GSOW material from the Wikipedia account, where we had put that he has been criticized as a fraud and a grief vampire, and even that the IIG gave him the truly terrible television award. So that made it into USA Today because GSOW added it to Wikipedia. How large are we? English Wikipedia has almost 34 million registered contributors, but only about 130,000 of those do it once a month. There are also a huge number of untracked contributors. We don't know what that number is, but there's at least 130,000 people who are serious about Wikipedia. We have 100 people. We're a very, very small fish in a large ocean that is Wikipedia. But we do think we make a difference, and I have some numbers on that. So what's our impact? We've been around for 8 years since Susan Gerbic, who's our founder and still she runs the organization, created us. We have about 100 editors, some are in training, and they're in many countries across the globe, or on the disk if you're a flat earther. And we have so far written 642 articles in many languages, which have now 27 million pages.
Wow.
That boggles my mind. We use this program, which someone wrote for us, in order to annotate for the team, or an editor, or a page, what it is. And the last number there is a total in the last 30 days. So we're approaching a million more views on our work every month. So why personally do I do this? Well, I'm part of that contribution, and I feel like I'm doing something. Previously, I argued with friends and relatives and coworkers, as I'm sure you all have, on social media. It does absolutely nothing, because they just don't believe you. But Wikipedia is used by people who maybe are looking for the truth, at least some of them. And hopefully this changes some minds. It gives me a great sense of accomplishment. And that's my individual number so far. In 2 years, I've written 18 articles. I've done countless smaller changes, and we don't track those numbers. But of those articles, I'm approaching a million page views just myself. So why not do this yourself? Why join this organization? Well, details of editing are daunting. The rules and guidelines of Wikipedia are daunting. You can learn them on your own. It takes a long time. And you get conflicts with editors who know what they're doing and revert your work. I did this before I joined GSOW a decade ago. Got really angry and didn't work on it for about 10 years. Going it alone, by my experience, can be extremely frustrating. So GSOW training and mentoring provides support and knowledge. You put it in a Facebook group with all the rest of us, and as you're learning, you can ask questions and people help. So my last thing is a pitch here. Help us make a difference. We can never do enough. Anyone here is interested? I have business cards. That's our email address. If you know anybody who you think is sitting around and like wants to spend some time doing this, take a card and give it to them, please. You can also look for our Guerrilla Skeptics promo on the Skeptic Zone. Yours truly got to do that, a little commercial. And as our promo says, join us, we educate the world even while we sleep. Thank you.
Tracking, you have any idea of tracking how many?
As far as I know, there's no way to do that.
Hard to do.
I'd love something like that. But that was an example. The example I showed around the Rousey came up sort of accidentally. One of our team members, we have all sorts of members, is a boxer himself, so he follows that. And he said, well, look at this. I think I saw this, and he checked it out. And he said, yes, we put that material on your Wikipedia page. But you're right. Some of our people have noticed on CNN, so it's not written down, it's hard to report. They'll make a report, and there it is. It's like, wow, they read the first two paragraphs in the Wikipedia article of the subject. sometimes it's an obituary from a scientist, sometimes it's a scientific thing, and it's like, yes, it's written that way accurately because, in part, my team had help doing that.
I'm just curious, with this group of people, how many people are registered as like a Wikipedia editor? Has anyone ever done that?
I do, like, occasionally. If somebody asks a question, repeat your question, or put the mic in front.
Okay, so the question was, how many here have done
Wikipedia?
Anyone
here has done this?
We got one other group, okay.
In 2009, Tim Farley did a presentation about editing Wikipedia, and I thought it was important.
So I did sign up, learned a little bit, made maybe 4 or 5 entries in the last 8 or 9 years, and this sounds like something that's a little more interesting.
So Tim Farley is one of the creative elements that caused us to exist.
Well, he got me to realize that I can edit Wikipedia.
So my understanding of the story is he was on a skeptical crew somewhere with Susan Garbick and others, and they were talking about Skepticamp, talking about what we can do to improve general knowledge. He came up with the idea of Wikipedia, and Susan ran with it. Anything else? Yes.
Have you ever heard of a guy named Gary Null who I think complains?
Yes, exactly. So the question was Gary Null complaining about us. Yes, there was a nice article which in my longer presentation I go into detail about that. Yes.
Is that the food guy?
No. He's just general medical woo, and he maybe does food too.
He has natural food books.
He does food too, okay. He attacked science-based medicine, all the articles on there, because like, hey, they're just trying to protect the medical establishment. And specifically, you're right, Susan Garbick and Guerrilla Skeptics on Wikipedia. And you know what? We wear that as a badge of honor. We actually, people, when they find that out, actually want to join the group and do more.
Do you have any comments on him? Specifically,
I don't know too much about him. I read that article, that's all I know. I frankly never heard of him before. He's in league with Rupert Sheldrake and Deepak Chopra, which we do know a lot about because they've also attacked us.
Yeah. He says he doesn't respect Chopra.
Oh, that's interesting.
But on the same vein, do they go in and fix back and you guys fit?
Well, as I kind of mentioned before, that it seems that the forces of the dark side don't know what they're doing. They're not organized. In fact, they basically make you know, the problem is they try to do things, and then they get reverted, not by us, just by all the other hundreds of thousands of editors on Wikipedia, and then they blame us. They make the logical fallacy that, you know, we know A is true, we know B is true, therefore A did B. It's like ridiculous, and that happens repeatedly. Yes?
And plus you have the advantage of having the facts on your side.
Yes, that's actually right.
You know, there's no reason to ruin something that's
actually
true.
Actually, I don't know if I got a minute here, the Lawrence Krauss affair that recently happened. You guys know about that? So there was a sub-problem with that, in that his article, which of course is a famous physicist and atheist activist, was being protected by having the BuzzFeed article, which is the first one that came out, regarding the accusations. And immediately, some skeptics, by that name, people in the movement, I'm not going to use names now, but they have podcasts, jumped to the conclusion GSRW is protecting his page. We have not seen it, we have not touched it. And it's become a big to-do. I have no idea why they were so logical themselves. Other Wikipedia editors were following the rules of Wikipedia. BuzzFeed is not a Wikipedia reliable source. When the New York Times went with it, then it became an item that could be on his article, which it is now. Anything else? Time out? Yes.
I just recommend everyone should sign up for Wikipedia because there's, if you're a specialist in any of your careers and you find something to add to an article and learn how to do it, it helps the whole encyclopedia in general.
This too
is another opportunity once you sign up and figure out. I still have just a small percentage of grasping out the rules and regulations.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I think I posted 4 or 5 things, 2 of them were taken down.
It's very frustrating.
And the rest are still up there, and it makes you feel good that you contributed to this giant encyclopedia that's free.
Thanks for helping.
That you can go ahead to.
And it's easy to do.
It is easier than you think. Just sign up and read the basic rules. And
yeah, making an account is easy, doing it right so that you know you notice your edits get taken off. If you don't do it right, that's a problem. Putting sources on, knowing what reliable sources are by Wikipedia standards, doing the sourcing correctly, citing it in the work, any of those things get done wrong, and an experienced editor says, no, this is nonsense, he hits one button and it's gone.
I mean, photo contributions, then they're still
yep, good. That's good.
So you can yes.
Do they contact you first to make revisions before they just take it down?
No, doesn't work that way.
Okay.
So yeah, the question was about revisions. Did I contact you? So well, maybe I shouldn't have said no immediately. If it's something that's not clear, there's a, every Wikipedia article has a talk page, which people just don't notice. It's a tab right next to read. And you can see the discussions between Wikipedia editors on what should go on the page. It's fascinating to read that on pretty much any controversial page. And in some cases, yes, they'll put something on talk and say, hey, see talk, I don't like what you did. Or they'll take it off and say, let's discuss it on talk before you put it back.
Okay.
Yeah. All right. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.